Backhand Hockey here with the sixth daily upload. Today we're going to be talking about a situation with the Canucks in free agency. The situation being, who did the Canucks need to keep? Tyler Toffoli, Jacob Markstrom, or Chris Tanev? These players are probably the three biggest Canucks free agents, and they're all impact players. Before we get into today's video, make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. We're on the road to 200 subs, so help me out by clicking that big red button. Like I mentioned earlier, these three players are all big impact players, and these three are all going to be highly sought after UFAs. Jacob Markstrom was debatably a top three goaltender in the league, and he has been pretty mediocre for most of his career, but he has kept up a solid rate of improvement. This season, he had a Vezina contending year, and he could sometimes steal games for the Canucks. And he's only making $3.6 million. So you'd be crazy not to expect him to ask for a raise.
Okay.
He is an elite goalie, and he is worth way more than $3.6 million. I think he could be valued somewhere in between $6 and $9 million. I think the Canucks will probably get him for $7 million because he has publicly said that he wants to stay in Vancouver, and that is his main offseason focus. So using this, the Canucks can probably push for a lower salary on him because they sort of have a negotiating advantage. Tyler Toffoli has been a top six forward for most of his career, and he has put up 20 to 30 goals for the most part. He has been a solid 40 plus point guy, and he is only 27, so he is in his prime. Toffoli had a down year last year with only 34 points, but he bounced back this season, and he tied his last year just in 58 games. And he was a point per game after getting traded to the Canucks. He is a guy that I'm very excited to see in the playoffs, and you could say he has a decent amount of experience, and I have been told he is a good person to be around, but who knows how accurate that is. He is heading into his prime. I could see him achieving 30 goals again, and there is a lot of good and bad potential because he could hit his prime and give some of his best playing, or he could go back to that dismal 30 points. Toffoli has been making $4.6 million for the past 5 years. You can 100% expect him to ask for a pay raise because he's a good player who will have little to no trouble finding a contract with good pay. I think that he is valued anything between $4.5 to $7 million. Personally, I think it is pretty unlikely that he gets signed for $7 million, but you never know, especially since you often end up overpaying for FAs. I think he'll most likely end up going for $6 million, as it is pretty reasonable because it's not giant, but it's not too small. Hopefully he doesn't end up being the next Louis Erickson because the Canucks cannot take another one of those contracts.
Mission failed. We'll get him next time.
Chris Tanev has been a top four defender for a large part of his career. He is pretty underrated, and he is a defensive defenseman, or as some of you call it, a stay-at-home defender. His offensive production isn't great because of his playstyle, but he has been one of the most valuable defensemen on the Canucks for years, and he is arguably one of the best, if not the best, defensive defensemen, as it is sort of a dying playstyle. Most teams realize how valuable he is and how much he helps defensively. He will definitely get quite a few offers if he makes it past the re-sign phase. Tanev has been making $4.4 million for the past 5 years, and I fully expect him to get a raise. I think he's worth around $4 to $6 million per year, and my prediction is that he'll get six because Tyler Myers makes six, and I think Tanev is a little better than Tyler Myers, so he deserves at least the same. The Canucks have to sign multiple other players like Jake Virtanen, Adam Gaudette, and Troy Stetcher. And next year, they have to re-sign Elias Pettersson, and he's someone you definitely don't want to lose. So they have quite the salary cap problem. I think the Canucks need to keep Jacob Markstrom because Demko isn't ready to be a full-time starter. And if Demko breaks out, then they can trade Jacob Markstrom, or, you know, they can still get rid of Demko. But personally, I don't think the Canucks should give up on Thatcher Demko yet because he is still young and there is still a while before the expansion draft. And like I said, they can always trade one of the goalies at the deadline. I think signing Markstrom lifts a lot of pressure off everyone, including Thatcher Demko and potentially Michael DiPietro if he gets called up. I think the Canucks need to sign Jacob Markstrom above everyone else. I also think the Canucks should keep Tyler Toffoli. Personally, I think Toffoli has a few great seasons ahead of him, and he adds a lot to the Canucks' top six forward unit. I'm pretty sure the Canucks will have some space to sign him, and I also don't want to see the Madden trade go to waste. I think in today's game, defense is valuable, but in my opinion, it is a scoring game nowadays. Even the D-men are scoring. And Tyler Toffoli can score, and score is what he'll do if we sign him. And the person I think the Canucks will let go is Chris Tanev. Yes, I want him to stay, but I just don't think it's possible. I don't know if he really wants to stay or not as well. But I just don't think it's possible. I'm pretty sure the Canucks can't squeeze in that contract. And personally, I'd rather keep someone like Troy Stetcher, who has more potential and is younger. After all, Tanev is 30 years old, turning 31. If the Canucks find a way to squeeze, then everyone is happy, but that's a pretty big if. And like I said, I'd rather keep the players who are young and have more potential, because we also need to think about the long term. Because although the Canucks might be contenders next year, that doesn't mean they should go all out. And nowadays, the two-way defender is sort of taking over the game with newcomers like Rasmus Dahlin and Miro Heiskanen. Plus, the Canucks have a strong defensive future with Olli Juolevi, Brogan Rafferty, and Chet Wu, and more. And I think some of these guys could actually play in the NHL next year. So, of the three players I mentioned today, Tanev is the one I would let go if I had to let someone go. But obviously, I want to keep them all, but I just don't think it's possible. So, I keep Toffoli, I keep Markstrom, and I get rid of Tanev. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. Tune in for more videos coming soon. And until next time, bye.